What do you think about Rhin? A sweet child. Strong-willed, given to wisdom and introspection. She reminds me of myself at her age. Still, we should examine her more closely. Some of the things she says and does border on delusions. Rhin says, I'm not sure I'm the one with delusions here. That's right, dear. Question those beliefs.
God.
I don't remember who this is.
Yes, lass?
The Children of the Gate. Yeah, I don't even remember them. Sorry, guys. How you holding up? I'm fine, lass. I just hope you won't regret our friendship when the time comes to part ways. Yeah, I'm wondering why he says that. What do you think about Rhin? Oh, I've been meaning to talk to you about this. What foolish notion made you think it was right to bring a little girl with us? People say I'm irresponsible, but this... Hey, Rhin says, glaring up at him. I may be a little, but at least I'm not a criminal. Was that an insult? He says, grinning. I hear it all the time. The word has lost its sting somewhat. Okay, done.
Fair enough.
Is that glow left over from Aratus? Look at this caravanserai, underbelly, Athai Tavern, Circus Minor this way. I'm not- oh, we gotta cut through this way? Alright. I'm not turning her in, guys, if I can help it.
Alright.
I know exactly where this Tol Maguur is.
When you talk to your gods, do they reply? Do their words echo in your mind, or is it simple emotion?
They just talk to me. Words, mostly.
Ah, well, one can mask their intentions behind pretty words, child.
Is that what you do? I thought you just liked the sound of your own voice.
Too bad they're coming in really low lately. So we are here, we need to go down here. There's another kiddo for you to play with. Yeah, they're all the way up here. But of course. Tol Maguur. Not Maguire. Mm-hmm. Ah, there's my little lost bird. Glad you found her. Now, just send her on over here and we'll count this job done. I don't want to go, she whispers. We need to talk about this, Tol. No, we don't. Just give me the girl and... She puts her hand to her face. Fine, fine. I didn't want to tell you this, but... Damn it. She grits her teeth. Here's my dirty secret, and if you tell anyone, I'll burn your flesh and scatter your bones. I'm a cast-off, like you. You want to know why I want the girl? It's because she helps control the tides in me. She keeps them from slipping out into the world. Without Rhin, everyone around me gets hurt, or even killed. If I use an adult for this, they die. So here's the deal. Give me the kid. I'll teach you how to control your tides better. Don't and... Well, let's not get into don't, eh? She holds out her hand to Rhin. No deal, Sporto. We'll have to settle this some other way. No. The time for talk is over. Whoa. She stares at you and you feel a sudden swirling in your psyche. A cacophony of dueling emotions. She's doing something with the tides. Filling you with sickness and despair, the overwhelming compulsion to lie down and sob. She stops, a grim smile on her face. You want an example of what cast-offs can do? You want to know why I want the girl? She stops me from doing that. Now give her to me. This is the bad option. This is the fight option. Another fight option, possibly. Did you use the tides on me? Is that what you do to Rhin? Frequently, she smirks. Do you have a problem with it? Well, that's horrible. She thinks it's better than the alternative. I'm not a leech or a killer. I'm not. Yeah, it took damage to intellect pool. Well, we got a lot of options here. Yeah, I'm definitely not giving her to her when she's going to be doing that to her frequently. You said Rhin keeps your powers from hurting or killing other people. How do you know it won't kill her? She looks away from you. From Rhin. I don't know. I can't bear the thought that it might. But these others here, they're my friends. If I lose Rhin, my powers might kill them. Persuasion. Hopefully the persuasion stays there and doesn't leave when choosing one of these options. Why can't you use one of your followers instead of Rhin? She sneers. Did you miss the part where adults die if I surge into them? Not an option. I don't want to leave a trail of the dead and dying in my wake. Apart from being, you know, evil, it raises questions from authority figures. Yeah, I know you said that. You should learn how to control your powers better. You don't need to use someone else as a sponge. That's what she thought, too, sponge. She spits, not quite at your feet, but certainly near them, says the cast-off who can't control her own tides. Enslaving Rhin is destroying her life and her potential anyway. One way or another, you're killing her. She's prepared an angry retort, but it dies on her lips. I don't... No. I'll let her go when... Damn it. How old does Rhin have to be before your powers kill her? She's pretty close already, isn't she? She shrugs, but she avoids your eyes. I don't know. What I do know is that if I don't use her, others will be hurt. Alright, let's try. I'm not sure what this means to exact some justice. So how can you justify keeping Rhin in, like, against us? I'm not sure. I don't want to choose that. So I don't know what that means. So how can you justify keeping Rhin in your custody? Release your claim. Nice.
Can we talk?
She grits her teeth. Fine. You've convinced me. You can keep her. But you treat her right, you hear? If I get even a hint that you've made Rhin unhappy, I'll track you across the ninth world. She concentrates a moment, and then the miasma that filled your mind lifts. And why does he want to talk? You know what? I'll even live up to my part of the bargain. I'm going to teach you about your tides, because it will help you keep Rhin safe. You ready for this? Does it hurt? Her lip hardly curls as she responds. Does it hurt to breathe? To walk? All I'm doing is showing you how to use your inborn power more effectively. Cool, this is what we wanted. She fights to keep the despairing sneer on her face. You know I hate all of this cast-off skist, yeah? Alright. So, the changing god. He made us. Maybe not on purpose, maybe we're just an accident, but he made us. He uses the tides to transfer his mind. You felt them, I'm sure. Surges of power, emotion, whatever. That's the tides, and they're pushing around inside you. You focus them into something, you can make a weapon out of them.
Cool.
Manifest differently for each of us. Most of us don't even think about it. But I figure, use every tool at your disposal. She breathes out. Close your eyes. Feel that coiling power in you? That's the tides. Now feel this. I'm going to push a little power at you. Try to fight it off. With your eyes closed, you can see the energy emanating from her, a dark and angry spike of red-hued power that drifts toward you. Okay, the red tide. Which is, basically can symbolize, anger, rage, like a domineering aspect. What's the word I'm trying to think of? Like ambition, that kind of thing. Instinctively, you raise your hands to bat it away, and she snorts. With your mind, use your tides. As the tidal dagger drifts closer, you feel something inside you uncoiling, a vast and restless power whose depths you can barely comprehend. It's reminiscent of the energy you used to blast the sorrow fragments from your mind, but now you can control it, and you breathe out, pushing her probe away. That's it. That's it. Practice that. We're done. Skill level in tidal affinity has been increased by 1. So we are now trained. Now that I know you're a cast-off, let's talk about you a little more. I'm not a core part of... it's not a core part of my identity, you know. I don't walk around thinking, oh, I'm a cast-off, let me think about my place in the world. She jabs a finger into your chest. I'm my own person. Got it? But fine. Ask your questions. Do you know anything about Matkina? She shrugs. I've heard the name. I know she trades with a bad crowd. I've never met her. Don't know where she lives or who she knows. Never hoped to, either. Don't particularly care to talk about her, or, you know, to her. I've said all I need to say. Do you know any other cast-offs? I knew Riostrad. Glaive, covered in living metal armor. He had some underworld connections. It didn't end well for him. Last I heard, he scrambled his brain trying to change his past with dodgy Numenera. For the rest of the cast-offs, no. I'll keep to myself, and I'll thank you to keep my existence a secret. What is it you hope to accomplish with your life? Why become a slaver when you're effectively immortal? She eyes you speculatively. Why? Because it was easy to fall into the life. Because it was a challenge to get good at it. Because I don't particularly care what others think about me. She rakes her hair back. This tattoo? It doesn't define me. I'm not the man who made me. I owe him nothing. I owe you nothing. I owe the world nothing. It's my life, and these are my choices. Don't you think you could do some good for people? What makes you think I'm not? Look, you're approaching this all wrong. You see slaves, and you think mistreatment. I see criminals and burdens. Sure, they're not going to find happier lives right away, but once they finish their service, they get to live. Most of them, anyway. So kiss my arse. This is good for them. And our gold tide raised a small amount, and we didn't get the... bling! Self-reflection is the key to a successful life. Blue tide. However you define a success, maybe, I'm perfectly happy doing what I need to, what I do. I don't need to be remembered. Oh yeah, I can increase the skill in that now that we have it. Or maybe it's good enough that it's just trained. She spits. If you don't have any other epiphanies you want to share with me, I've got some important none-of-your-business to attend to. Do you know anything about the sorrow? The what? She looks genuinely puzzled for a moment. Oh, you mean that monster that looks like the knight mated with some year-old corpses? I don't. Nothing that would be helpful anyway. I felt it a while back, though. She shivers. Felt like it glanced my way. Felt like it told me, not yet. She shakes herself free of the memory. But no, can't help you with anything about it. It was a nightmare. I don't talk about my dreams. You're telling me about the tides. She eyes you warily. What about them? What's the deal with the girl Rhin? She caught my pain. When the tides well up in me and overflow, she took the excess and kept me from hurting others. Don't know how, but it was a service. Without her, these others around me, they take the brunt. And while they liked the experience in small amounts, any larger surge poisons them. Really, they liked the experience? Lays them low. It's even killed a couple. So the girl's essential to the well-being of those around me. She's a sponge for the excess energy that my body makes. That's that. What's the deal with your followers? They seem a little strange. She gives them a quick glance. They are. Rhin filtered, I guess, my tides. I turn my energy outward, and it makes most people sick. But Rhin changed that. Instead of making them sick, it gave them hallucinations. Pleasant dreams, a euphoria that improves their days. Right now they're suffering because I've been bleeding off into them, slowly. Bad combination. They're good people. Good to have at your back in a fight. She reconsiders. Well, my back, anyway. I'd like to talk about these tidal surges. Why? It's different for each of us. I can't tell you how the world looks through your eyes, or what something tastes like on your tongue. You gotta figure that out on your own. I can't tell you that you don't like meat, or that you think, I don't know, fungus is delicious. You see the world your own way. It's what makes you. Why am I even telling you this? It's remedial experiential philosophy. They're a birthright, side effect of being cast-offs of the changing god. I've got nothing more to say on the subject because I don't know anything else about it. That. Slavery and Sagus points. Sagus Cliffs. What's the point? We catch the people who deserve to be slaves. They work off their punishment in the bloom. That's it. And Sagus Cliffs? What part of Ask Someone Who Cares did you not get? Farewell. Sure.
What's going on?
Why can't I read your mind? She takes two steps away from you. You can read minds? You're trying to read my mind? Not exactly. I hear people's surface thoughts sometimes, but not yours. It's like you don't have any. That... Why would you be doing that to me? To not offend people. It's not something I choose to do. You hear people's voices whether you want to or not. For me, their thoughts are the same. Her eyebrows rise. Oh, I didn't realize. It's still pretty invasive. I wish you didn't have to hear it. It helps keep me alive. Ooh, indigo tide raises a small amount. She shakes her head. Well, it's not a good thing. You have to know that. It's like eavesdropping. But it's worse than that, because it's more private than a regular conversation. What happens in your head is just for you. It's a conversation a person is having with just themselves. Nothing is more private than that. She hesitates, then continues in a soft voice. When a god is strong enough to see into someone's mind, it's a sign the god might be too dangerous. It's a bad thing. She breaks off suddenly, then reaches into her pocket and pulls out her stone. She stares at it with the slightly vacant expression she gets sometimes, then speaks directly to the stone. I haven't been keeping it from you, Al. There's a lot of things I never told you. It's something I've never... Another pause, and her face grows increasingly concerned. Everyone knows, Al. Sometimes a god goes bad. When that happens... She breaks off, head cocked slightly to one side. Her face is growing concerned. Continue listening. Well, if a god can move by itself, that's a big one. If it argues constantly with other gods or refuses to talk at all, those are signs that... She stops again, listening. Then you're supposed to take it to the... I can't remember their name. The god fixers. Rhin rubs her forehead with her free hand. I can't remember what they're called. She looks up, her face worried. Oh, I'm sorry. We can talk about this later, Al. We're being rude. She puts the stone back in her pocket and blinks a little as if to clear her head. I don't know why you can't get into my head. Maybe kids' brains are different? Or maybe just my brain? Or maybe that sort of thing doesn't work on people where I'm from? I really don't know. No, I can read kids' thoughts. Oh, God. Could it be Al? Could he be hiding your thoughts from me? He is the god of hiding, right? She looks surprised at this suggestion, then gives one of the widest smiles you've ever seen. She reaches into her pocket again, brings out the stone, and holds it in front of her face. Is it true, Al? Are you keeping my thoughts hidden? She pauses, head cocked to one side, then she laughs and gives the stone a kiss. She looks up at you. You were right. He's the one that's doing it. And I'm glad. What's in a person's head is private. You shouldn't go prying into it. That's not what friends do. Okay. Right. Come on, Rhin. We never hurt you. But Tol's hurting us now. You're not getting Rhin. Word of advice. Don't argue with Tol. Give her what she wants and get out. Yeah, I'm getting out. So it was a long episode, guys, so I just wanted to wrap this up. So this is awesome. What I'm going to do right now before we sign off... Let me just look at this. I do have title affinity. Hold on a second. I can't. Unlocks more difficult title surge options. Allows the last cast off greater control and finesse with the tides, granting access to increasingly complex ways of manipulating people and objects with those forces with the title surges. Okay, I'm not going to increase this yet because what if I need it even more trained, right? Well, I can always put that thing on, right? Yeah, what the hell, increase it. I'm gonna choose another skill. So I have persuasion as regular untrained. Because I do want to be able to use that sometimes. I mean, I have been using it. But I'm assuming as the game continues, as the story continues on, it's going to have some harder and harder things to do. Deception is not really what my character is about, so I'm going to be more persuading whenever possible. So next time I might actually put a skill, a trained skill, into that.
You don't like me, do you?
Yeah, does anyone know him? So thanks for watching, guys. Next time, going down to talk with the Stika. We don't have too much more to go. This one... Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on with that. I'm not going to convince the guy to, like... I don't know. I need to convince him to kill himself or make himself blind or something crazy like that. I'm not going to do that. I want to find another way around this. That's the whole thing of that. The airship thief. Maybe if I help with this, then what's her name down there? She's from the council. So maybe we can help with Aretas. We need the, you know, what do you call it? The backing of, I need the backing of someone influential. So that might help there. And then Mother Tamaz, we can't really do that because she's gone. We were too late. So I guess this quest is never going away. Unless we go somewhere else and we find her down below. Who knows? So thanks for watching. See you next time and enduring. Grow strong.